Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to this quick tutorial, which is about exporting my Unity application and use it as a module inside Android Studio. So in this tutorial, I will be creating a Unity app and export the app and use it inside an Android Studio project. And we will also be writing methods for sharing live data between the two. So first thing is to create a project inside Unity. Now let's quickly create a UI where we are going to see our data. And for the UI, I will be creating a background, a field to display data, a button to generate random number which will be sent over, and a button to open the Android app from the Unity app. Let's also create a script and name it as Mediator and assign it to the canvas and open it. So we need a reference to the data field as it will display our data which we will send and receive. Let's quickly assign the reference as well. Now let's write the steps of implementation. So firstly, the Android app will open. Then the user will click on the button in the Android app. In the third step, the button will open the Unity instance. In the fourth step, the user will perform some actions or some functions inside the Unity app based on the data received and then send the data before closing it. In the fifth and final step, the Android app will again take over and the data sent by the Unity app will be displayed. So these are the steps. The first three steps will be done on the Android side. So let's implement the fourth and the fifth step. So assuming we have the data already available in the Android app, I'll simply ask the data by calling the Android classes. And these are the steps. First, get the Unity class, and from the class, get the object, and from the object, call the method. Now after receiving the data, we are going to display it inside our text field. Now let's create a method to generate a random number and display it in the text field as well. Switch to Unity and assign the reference and test it. So it's working fine. Let's implement the final step, and that is to send the data to the Android app. And for that, same technique will be used. That is to get the class, and from the class, get the object, and from the object, call a method. But this time the method will pass the string data. So there's one mistake that I've made, and that is to create a new object. Instead, we need to get the object from the class. So here is the final code. Also, let's change the method to set data for Unity. Now we have two methods. One will fetch data and another will send data. Let's save the project and export it. So here are the settings for exporting. I haven't changed any setting except few, such as I've added the company name and the product name. I've also changed the minimum API version to 7.0 NuGet, and everything remains the same. So we are done with the Unity app. Let's export it. So until it's exporting, let's open Android Studio and create a new project and select empty views activity. I'm not going to change the name or the package name of the project, but the language should be Java, not Kotlin, and press finish. Now the first step is to declare the Unity library. I've already wrote down all the steps in a notepad file. You can find this in the description below. The first step is to open settings.gradle and copy these lines and paste it at the bottom of the file. We also have to mention the path for the Unity library. Currently, we have not copied the library at this location as we will be doing it after next step. Now the next step is to copy and paste these lines inside build.gradle under implementation tag. This file belongs to our Android application. Press the build button and it will build successfully. And you will see the Unity library folder in the hierarchy. Now we need to copy the exported Unity project here. We do not need the complete export, only the Unity library folder. So simply copy and paste it inside the root of the project. Now let's build it and you will see the integration error, which will be solved one by one. Let's open the notepad and copy these lines and paste it at the bottom of the gradle.properties. Now the next step is to paste these lines inside the build.gradle of Unity's library. And the code will go under the Android tag. Now if we build the project, it won't be able to merge the manifest. So I've already edited the Unity's manifest and I will simply override it with the edited one. Now let's build it and it will work fine. There's one more step to do. Simply copy this line and paste it inside our string.xml, which can be found under app/java/res/values. This one belongs to the Android app. Now the app integration is ready. For the next step, we also need an interface. And if you remember, we need to implement the first three steps which we defined earlier. Let's first add a UI. I've already created a simple UI in the Android app. This is the code which I've added inside activity_main.xml. This button will open our Unity app and this field will display the data which will be sent by Unity. Let's write the code for this. So let's open the main activity and first define the integer launch second activity. This is basically the ID of our second activity, which is the Unity activity. Value could be anything, so don't worry about it. Now this is the code which will open the Unity app. Here I have fetched the button from the UI and added a click event, which will simply open the Unity activity. And we are also adding the data from our Unity app, which will be fetched and used from the Unity itself. Then I'm just starting the activity. Now we need one method which will receive the data sent from the Unity app and display it inside a field in the Android app. The code is simple. I'm fetching the data from the activity and displaying it inside the field. Don't forget, when you send data to the other activity, the tag needs to be the same. In our case, we are using the result string as a tag. Now we are almost done. We need to add few line of code to the Unity player activity as well. So the first method is getData from Unity, which will simply read the data sent from the main activity and pass it to the calling method, which in our case is Unity's start method. The next method is setData from Unity. When you press the button inside the Unity app to switch to the Android app, the Unity will call this method and pass the data. We are simply passing the data to the Android app and calling the finish method here to terminate the Unity app. And when the data will be sent from the Unity, we will read it inside this onActivityResult method inside MainActivity. There's one thing to remember. The Unity app is doing nothing to start or close itself. Everything is getting done using the Android's native method. So this completes our tutorial. Let's see the result. So that concludes our video. If you like the video, drop a like and subscribe the channel to show your support.